Paolo Trubetskoy, figure of a woman, 1890. The Prince Paolo Trubetskoy is born in Verbania. His father is a Russian diplomatic and a prince. His mother is an American pianist. He forms himself in an almost self-taught way under the guidance of Ernesto Bazzaro and Joseph Grandi as for sculpture. Instead, he will rely on Daniel Ronzoni to learn painting. He's a charming man, a Belle Epoque protagonist, a polyglot. He does just part of the international aristocracy that he will often portray in his sculptures. He travels all over the world. He knows Rodin's works and he wins a Grand Prix in Paris. He teaches at the Academy of Fine Arts in Russia, and he also travels to Hollywood in the United States. But he is always deeply attached to the Lake Major in Pallanza, there still in his Neogothic style villa. In this plaster sculpture, he represents a young woman, very beautiful and elegant, presumably standing, even if we can only see the naked bust. We can also see the drapery covering the legs, the slender arms stretching to the back of the body, almost in a light dance.
Vittoria Grubisi de Dragon, Winter Poem, The Valley of the Tours, 1897. This painting is part of a series of 8 cavances that make up the Winter Poem. Vittoria Grubisi, a collector merchant, approaches the technique of divisionists and takes the idea of impressionist painters to represent atmospheric effects, like Monet did in his paintings, where the subject does not change. It's just the light and the time that are different. This painting represents the Tours River that originates in the Formazza Valley and flows into Lake Maggiore. In this room, the works are exhibited following the directives of the artist. We also need to remember that in this room we can see works by Longoni, a painter sponsored by Grubisi and patron and art dealer.
Emilio Longoni, Alpine Landscape, 1920. Longoni is a Lombard painter. He is the fourth of 12 sons and, from his early age, he develops a passion for painting. So, after working as an apprentice, he is sent to work with a painter of square billboards in Milan. He must earn for living and, during his life, he makes many jobs, even the room painter. When he finally attends the Brera's Academy, he obtains many positive awards. In his professional way, Longoni is supported and sponsored by a patron, a collector and artist, who exposes in this same hall. His name is Vittor Grubisi. In this work, he shows an alpine landscape with a lake and the typical haze that appears in the mountain lakes. The plateau is large and covered of green grass. On background, mountains can be seen. Nature is predominant and a small human figure in holy intent far away. This work should be seen closely. Longoni knows personally Segantini, and with him he gets asked with the pointless movement. That's why we can see many tiny touches of color in every part of painting. Every color is the result of poor colors. Green is not completely so, and even the blue of the sky, if well analyzed, consists also of pink and violet.
Emilio Longoni, Alpine Transparencies, 1910. Longoni, a Lombard painter with a very large family, seems almost to seek in the Alpine landscapes the quiet and tranquility that probably he didn't have in his family. Emilio Longoni had many jobs in his life. In fact, he worked as art painter, poster designer, and then he started to paint portraits and still life painting for the Milanese aristocracy and bourgeoisie. In his studio in Via Stella, the current Via Cordoni 45, there were all kinds of clients, from the banker Torelli to the Travers brothers. Longoni became famous and well appreciated at the first Triennale of Brera. This kind of painting where the nature is the protagonist and the human being is reduced to a minimum, is opposed to its not so pleasant life. Longoni was also involved in the tumults of 1898 in Milan, and he was considered a painter of the anarchists. In his pictorial works, where the sun is intangible and we almost can't breathe, the crisp air of mountains, often the massive of Bernina, he uses the divisionist technique that reaches the nuances and different colors, only combining tiny brushstrokes of pure colors.